Sex hormone binding globulin is a protein that transports androgens and estrogens in the bloodstream. Also, this protein regulates the access of sex hormones to target tissues. The major concept that we have to know is that lipophilic hormones in free state are active. In free state, they can penetrate into the tissues, where they can affect the cellular metabolism. But once protein binds them, they immediately become inactivated. In binded state, they cannot go anywhere. Sex hormone binding globulin is produced by the liver. So logically, if something happens to liver, the level of this protein will decrease. And the major function of this protein is to bind and thereby to inactivate sex hormones. The most common pathology that affects the level of sex hormone binding globulin is cirrhosis. So let's explain the pathogenic mechanism. Let's suppose that it's a male patient. In the blood we have androgens and estrogens. Because it's a male patient, the level of androgens is higher. Sex hormones in free state can penetrate directly into the tissues, and by this they can alter the metabolism of cells. What we have to keep in mind is that lipophilic hormones do not need receptor to affect the metabolism of the cell. They can penetrate directly, it's their superpower. But also, we have some sex hormones in reserve. But we need to keep them inactive because we already have enough active sex hormones. So to solve the problem, liver produces a specific protein called sex hormone binding globulin. Even from the name, we can guess what this protein is doing. Sex hormone binding globulin binds to both androgens and estrogens. And in binded state, sex hormones become inactive. So by this we can have substantial amount of sex hormones in reserve. The most common pathology that affects the level of sex hormone binding globulin is cirrhosis. In cirrhosis, the quantity of hepatocytes decreases. And without hepatocytes, we cannot produce sex hormone binding globulin. So the level of this protein decreases. And now, with decrease in sex hormone binding globulin, we do not have proteins to keep sex hormones in reserve. So they become free, and free means that they become active. The problem with active lipophilic hormones is that we cannot control them. In male patients, the excessive amount of free estrogens cause substantial hormonal disbalance. Hyperestrogenemic effect will provoke gynecomastia, spider angiomata, palmar erythema, and decreased libido. In women, increase in free androgens also provokes hormonal disbalance that typically manifests as dysregulation of the menstrual cycle. The second pathology that can affect the level of sex hormone binding globulin is obesity. Obesity causes increase in estrogens production. As a result, the level of estrogens in the blood increase. The problem is that increasing amount of free estrogens will cause hyperestrogenemic effect on tissues. And especially if you're a man, probably decreased libido is not what you dreamed about. So organism tries to correct hyperestrogenemia by increasing production of sex hormone binding globulin. Now, at least some estrogens can be binded to sex hormone binding globulin. And by this we can convert active free estrogens into inactive binded estrogens. And thereby we can decrease estrogenemic effect on peripheral tissues. So in mild obesity, person has increased level of estrogens, increased sex hormone binding globulin, free androgens are normal, initially free estrogens are normal, but the level of binded estrogens is high. But if obesity progresses, sex hormone binding globulin will not correct this, because the liver capacity to produce sex hormone binding globulin is limited, and thereby, in obese people, the level of free estrogens is significantly elevated.